all energy is the mind. There is no other energy. Is there energy without matter? Is there energy without the world? When you have a lot of things to think of, then you only get muddling up. Let me just make it simpler for you. There is the self, which is all and nothing, and everything else that you can think of, talk of, touch, feel, sense, smell is mind. Nothing is energy. If you can touch energy, it is mind. If you are thinking of energy, it is mind. Do not talk of too many things. There aren't too many things. There are just very few things, and they too get reduced to nothing.
What about like chakras, energy channels, nada, bingo, and all that?
And there is a hole here, friend. You know,
Sahasra.
Brahmarandra, and you know, well, come on. When two things are interchangeable, nothing is more fundamental than the other. They are one. Yes, yes, Prakriti. Yes. Yes. So? Yes, it is. So what? It's all the mind. Would you be talking of these things if you are asleep? It is the mind, the consciousness, that's all. Why must we make such big stories out of simple matters? Spirituality is about seeing the simple in the complex. Do not complicate any further. Our lives are already very complex. When I am throwing a stone at you, the stone coming towards you is energy. It is also hurt. It is also hatred. It is also ego. It is also time and space. They are all one. Energy is hurt. Energy is ego. Energy is time. When I am talking about objects, is there any object, sense, energy? So why are you talking of energy as if it is something special and different? Objects are energy. The stone coming at you is energy. The passion for a woman is energy. Is there energy without a woman? They are all one. The stone that is coming towards you is both ego and energy. It is mind and space and time and anger and nationalism and knowledge and everything else that you can think of or conceptualize. It is all.